Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to another video on Jetpack Compose, and we will continue to explore side effects in Composable. So far, we have covered these many side effects. In this video, we will have a look at side effect and disposable effect. As name indicates, disposable effect is executed when the composable is getting disposed of. You mean to say when it is getting unrendered. If launched effect was getting executed at the start time of the composable, the disposable effect is exact opposite end of that. That is when the composable is getting closed. So you typically write most of the clearing of the resources kind of logic in the disposable effect. And in case of side effect, if you want to execute something every time the composable gets updated, then side effect is the one that you need to go for. And as you can see from the color code, side effect is not lifecycle aware. When I say not lifecycle aware, in a classical sense, the onCreate, onPause, onResume callback methods of the activity or the fragment that I am talking about. So side effect is not dependent on that. Of course, it is dependent on what happens to the composable itself, but not in a classical callback methods of the activity and fragment. But that is not the case with disposable effect. It is very much aware of the life cycle of the activity or the fragment. So let's get into a demo and see how to actually use this. It is the same old codebase that I am using from the previous demo, which was used for demonstrating the purpose of remember updated state. We are going to just update this particular code to demonstrate disposable. So let me go back to the first composable, the parent composable, which is main screen. And this is the counter message. Counter message is being used within the main screen. So what I will do is, here I will write disposable effect, and just like launched effect also takes a key one parameter, the disposable effect also takes key one parameter. As of now, we will use unit. The purpose is exactly similar to the way we had used unit with launched effect, which we have discussed earlier, which is to basically make sure that it doesn't get executed every time some state changes. So unit doesn't change. You can use even true, the boolean value, but right now I am using unit. And then you basically write on dispose, and in on dispose you can write any log statement. Typically you write any logic where you are clearing the resources. You might be having a reference to a file or a shared preference or a hardware resource like a camera. Just before you close the composable, it is a good idea to unregister your composable from the usage of that particular hardware or any of such resources. So I will use disposable effect itself as a tag, and then use on dispose getting invoked. And now let me run this code. And as usual, what we will do is we will see whether this on dispose effect is getting executed or not. The one that you were seeing earlier in the logcat was from the earlier session where I was trying out certain things. So let me just execute it from the beginning. So you can see that a lot of things are getting executed. The rendering is happening, the counter is happening, a lot of things are getting executed. But after the counter ends, you are not seeing disposable effect getting logged because this particular composable is not yet closed. When I close this, that is when on dispose getting invoked actually gets executed. So as I told earlier, this is lifecycle aware, and as you close the composable, that is when the disposable effect gets executed. So this is exact opposite of launched effect. Now, instead of unit or true, what I can do is I can use some state, say for example, counter. Let's just observe what happens in this case. Look at every time the counter value changes, you are basically seeing the log of on dispose getting executed. Typically, this is not done because you don't want your disposable effect to get executed every time some state changes, unless you really have a strong case to use it in this way. So this is just for demonstration purpose, but otherwise you typically don't need this. It is always used with unit or true, or some people even pass a context. So that is about the disposable effect, which gets executed when you are about to close your composable. So between this launched effect and the disposable effect, there is one more side effect, which is simple side effect. And in side effect, whatever that you write, it always gets executed. So how you write is, just to make it simple, let me write a side effect. And as you can see, it is just a block of code. It doesn't take any parameter. And then let me just log something here. Instead of disposable effect, let me call it as side effect, and side effect is getting invoked. Now let me just stop this, use this in my logcat and restart the application. And you can see that every time the counter changes, you actually see a side effect is getting invoked. So every time the composable gets rendered, due to anything, doesn't matter, if it gets re-rendered, the side effect gets re-executed every time. So this is once again completely dependent on what's happening in the composable. This is not dependent upon whether the composable is getting closed or opened. So for example, what I mean to say is, if I close this, you won't see a side effect getting executed, because it is not related to the lifecycle. It is not lifecycle aware in the classical sense. But if something happens to the composable, if it gets rendered or re-rendered, every time the re-rendering happens, the side effect is getting invoked. Now, the obvious question that you probably want to ask is, why would I do it and when would I use it? Let's assume that we have another state variable wherein we want to maintain a state of a counter having not started, completed, and in progress. So every time the counter changes, you have to manipulate this thing immediately. Let me show you. First of all, let me create a enum called as counter state. Let me go back here. This is the enum counter state. It has three states: not started, in progress, and completed. And then if you come down here inside the side effect, what I can do is, when counter is zero, I can maintain another state. Let me call it as counter state by, remember, mutable state of counter state dot initial state can be not started. And then I can set this counter state. If it is zero, I can say not started. If it is 10, counter state would be completed. Else counter state would be in progress. And based on what counter state actually holds, you probably want to do some complicated logic. So what I will do is use this counter state to be logged here. Let me clear this and let me run this. So side effect is getting invoked. It is initially not started, and then every time it is before 10, it only logs in progress. And after that, it basically shows completed. I think we are not seeing completed because this is not logged after the state has changed. I can basically put it after this. And now if I rerun this, you can see that it starts with not started, goes through many iterations of in progress, and then finally it shows completed. And this is exactly what we want. We are not displaying this state anywhere in our application, but we might choose to do something with this state that we are maintaining for some internal logic. Who knows? Probably we want to fetch some kind of an icon based on what state it is and display something on the screen. But icon getting displayed and this state itself displayed are two different things. We are not directly displaying this state. There are many people who do that mistake, that is, they do manipulate something here in the side effect and then also use it for rendering purpose. I would suggest don't do it, because this is getting executed on the UI thread. It's not like it is getting executed on the coroutine scope, just like in launched effect or disposable effect. And if by mistake this change happens very quickly and that need to be rendered immediately, it might affect the performance of your application. So that's it in this particular video. We have got one more side effect to discuss, that is produce state. So stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.